Good morning. We were hoping to come to you from the church so that we could all be in the church, but we were experiencing some Wi-Fi problems. So I'm coming to you from the Christian Healing House, and everyone else is in their home. So welcome to our Good Friday service. This is the celebration of the Lord's Passion. It's a very meditative service. There will be periods of silence for contemplation. Our Lord was handed over to suffering and death last night in the scriptures. It's a very solemn time, and it helps as we recall his death to really embrace what his sacrifice means to each and every one of us in our lives. Christ became obedient unto death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Christ the Lord became obedient unto death, even death on a cross. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We pray you of your mercy. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life to the glory of your name. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, look graciously, we pray, on this your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed and given into the hands of sinners, and to suffer death upon the cross. And he now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
Were you there when they nailed him to the tree?
Were you there when they nailed him to the tree?
Sometimes it causes me to tremble.
Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb?
Were you there when they laid him in the tomb?
Sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they laid him the tomb.
The proclamation of the word. A reading from Isaiah chapter 52 and chapter 53. See, my servant will act wisely. He will be raised and lifted up and highly exalted. Just as there were many who were appalled at him, his appearance was so disfigured beyond that of any human being, and his form marred beyond human likeness. So he will sprinkle many nations, and kings will shut their mouths because of him. For what they were not told, they will see. And what they have not heard, they will understand. Who has believed our message? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? He grew up before him like a tender shoot, and like a root out of dry ground. He had no beauty or majesty to attract us to him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by mankind. A man of suffering and familiar with pain. Like one from whom people hide their faces, he was despised, and we held him in low esteem. Surely he took our pain and bore our suffering, yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions, he was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before its shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth. By oppression and judgment he was taken away. Yet who of his generation protested? For he was cut off from the land of the living. For the transgression of my people he was punished. He was assigned a grave with the wicked, and with the rich in his death, though he had done no violence, nor was any deceit in his mouth. Yet it was the Lord's will to crush him and cause him to suffer. And though the Lord makes his life an offering for sin, he will see his offspring and prolong his days, and the will of the Lord will prosper in his hand. After he has suffered, he will see the light of life and be satisfied. By his knowledge, my righteous servant will justify many, and he will bear their iniquities. Therefore, I will give him a portion among the great, and he will divide the spoils with the strong. Because he poured out his life unto death and was numbered with the transgressors. For he bore the sin of many and made intercession for the transgressors. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Psalm 22. My God, why have you forsaken me?
Why are you so far from saving me, so far from my cries of anguish?
My God, I cry out by day, but you do not answer. By night, but I find no rest.
Yet you are enthroned as the Holy One. You are the one Israel praises.
In you our ancestors put their trust. They trusted, and you delivered them.
To you they cried out and were saved. In you they trusted and were not put to shame.
But I am a worm and not a man. Scorned by everyone, despised by the people.
All who see me mock me. They hurl insults, shaking their heads.
He trusts in the Lord, they say. Let the Lord rescue him.
Let him deliver him, since he delights in him.
Yet you brought me out of the womb. You made me trust in you, even at my mother's breast.
From birth I was cast on you. From my mother's womb you have been my God.
Do not be far from me, for trouble is near, and there is no one to help.
Many bulls surround me. Strong bulls of Bashan encircle me.
Roaring lions that tear their prey open their mouths wide against me.
I am poured out like water, and all my bones are out of joint.
My heart has turned to wax. It is melted within me.
My mouth is dried up like a boxard, and my tongue sticks to the roof of my mouth. You lay me in the dust of death.
Dogs surround me. A pack of villains encircle me. They pierce my hands and my feet.
All my bones are on display. People stare and gloat over me.
They divide my clothes among them and cast lots for my garments.
But you, Lord, do not be far from me. You are my strength. Come quickly to help me.
Deliver me from the sword, my precious life from the power of the dogs.
Rescue me from the mouth of the lions. Save me from the horns of the wild oxen.
I will declare your name to my people in the assembly. I will praise you. You who fear the Lord, praise him.
All you descendants of Jacob, honor him. Revere him, all you descendants of Israel.
For he has not despised or scorned the suffering of the afflicted one.
He has not hidden his face from him, but has listened to his cry for help.
From you comes the theme of my praise in the great assembly. Before those who fear you, I will fulfill my vows.
The poor will eat and be satisfied. Those who seek the Lord will praise him. May your hearts live forever.
All the ends of the earth will remember and turn to the Lord, and all the families of the nations will bow down before him.
For dominion belongs to the Lord, and he rules over the nations.
All the rich of the earth will feast and worship. All who go down to the dust will kneel before him, those who cannot keep themselves alive.
Posterity will serve him. Future generations will be told about the Lord.
They will proclaim his righteousness, declaring to a people yet unborn, he has done it. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Deacon Pam is now going to read the Gospel. Let us remember that the term Jews refers to specific people during that time. The people involved, not the whole race. Insofar as we turn ourselves against our Lord Jesus Christ, we are all responsible for his death.
A reading from the Gospel of John, chapter 19, verses 17 to 30. And carrying the cross by himself, he went out to what is called the place of the skull, which in Hebrew is called Golgotha. There they crucified him with two others, one on either side, with Jesus between them. Pilate also had an inscription written and put on the cross. It read, "Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews." Many of the Jews read this inscription because the place where Jesus was crucified was near the city, and it was written in Hebrew, in Latin, and in Greek. Then the chief priests of the Jews said to Pilate, "Do not write, 'The King of the Jews,' but 'This man said I am the King of the Jews.'" But Pilate answered, "What I have written, I have written." When the soldiers had crucified Jesus, they took his clothes and divided them into four parts, one for each soldier. They also took his tunic. Now the tunic was seamless, woven in one piece from the top. So they said to one another, "Let us not tear it, but cast lots for it, to see who will get it." This was to fulfill what the scripture says, "They divided my clothes among themselves, and for my clothing they cast lots." And that is what the soldiers did. Meanwhile, standing near the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, "Woman, here is your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home. After this, when Jesus knew that all was now finished, he said, in order to fulfill the scripture, "I am thirsty." A jar full of sour wine was standing there. So they put a sponge full of the wine on a branch of hyssop and held it to his mouth. When Jesus had received the wine, he said, "It is finished." Then he bowed his head and gave up his spirit.
I don't know how to love him, what to do, how to move him. I've been changed, yes, really changed. In these past few days, when I see myself, I see like someone else. I don't know how to take them. I don't see why he moves me. He's a man. He's just a man. And I've had so many men before in very many ways. He's just one more. Should I bring him down? Should I scream and shout? Should I speak of love? Let my feelings out. I never thought I'd come to that. What's it all about? Don't you think it's rather funny? I should be in this position. I'm the one who's always been so calm, so cool, not ever cool, running every show. He scares me so. Should I break him down? Should I scream and shout? Should I speak of love? Let my feelings out. I never thought I'd come to them. What's it all about? Yet if he said he loved me, I'd be lost, I'd be bright, and I couldn't cope, just couldn't cope. I turn my head, I back away, I wouldn't want to know. He scares me so, I want him so. I love him
so. Dear people of God, our Heavenly Father sent his Son into the world not to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved, that all who believe in him might be delivered from the power of sin and death and become heirs with him of eternal life. Let us pray for the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church of Christ throughout the world, for its unity and witness and service, for all bishops and other ministers and the people whom they serve, for Andrew Asbill, our diocesan bishop, and the College of Bishops, and all the people of this diocese, for all Christians in this community, for those about to be baptized, that the Lord will confirm his church in faith, increase it in love, and preserve it in peace.
Almighty and everlasting God, by your Spirit, the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified. Receive our supplications and prayers, which we offer before you for all members of your holy church, that in our vocation and ministry, we may truly and devoutly serve you through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Let us pray for all nations and peoples of the earth, and for those in authority among them, for Elizabeth, our Queen, and all the royal family, for Justin Trudeau, the Prime Minister, and for the government of this country, for Doug Ford, the Premier of this province, and the members of the legislature, for Rick Milne, the Mayor of this municipality, and all those who serve with him on the new Tecumseh Council, for all who serve the common good, that by God's help they may seek justice and truth and live in peace and concord.
Almighty God, kindle, we pray, in every heart the true love of peace, and guide with your wisdom those who take counsel for the nations of the earth, that justice and peace may increase until the earth is filled with the knowledge of your love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray for all who suffer. And are afflicted in body or in mind, for the hungry and homeless, the destitute and the oppressed, and all who suffer persecution or prejudice, for the sick, the wounded, and the handicapped, for those in loneliness, fear, and anguish, for those who face temptation, doubt, and despair, for the sorrowful and the bereaved, for prisoners and captives and those in mortal danger, that God in his mercy will comfort and relieve them and grant them the knowledge of his love and stir up in us the will and patience to minister to their needs.
Gracious God, the comfort of all who sorrow, the strength of all who suffer, hear the cry of those in misery and need, and give us, we pray, the strength to serve them for the sake of him who suffered for us, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray for all who have not received the gospel of Christ, for all who have not heard the words of salvation, for all who have lost their faith, for all whose sin has made them indifferent to Christ, for all who actively oppose Christ by word or deed, for all who are enemies of the cross of Christ and persecutors of his disciples, for all who in the name of Christ have persecuted others, that God will open their hearts to the truth and lead them to faith and obedience.
Merciful God, creator of the peoples of the earth and lover of souls. Have compassion on all who do not know you, as you are revealed in your Son, Jesus Christ. Let your gospel be preached with grace and power to those who have not heard it. Turn the hearts of those who resist it and bring home to your fold those who have gone astray, that there may be one flock under one shepherd, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us commit ourselves to God and pray for the grace of a holy life, that with all who have departed this life and have died in the peace of Christ, and those whose faith is known to God alone, we may be accounted worthy to enter into the fullness of the joy of our Lord and receive the crown of life in the day of resurrection.
O God of unchangeable power and eternal light, look favorably on your whole church, that wonderful and sacred mystery. By the effectual working of your providence, carry out in tranquility the plan of salvation. Let the whole world see and know that things which were cast down are being raised up, and things which had grown old are being made new, and that all things are being brought to their perfection by him through whom all things were made, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
This is the wood of the cross on which hung the Savior of the world. Come, let us worship. Is it nothing to you all who pass by? Look and see if there is any sorrow like my sorrow, which was brought upon me, which the Lord inflicted on the day of his fierce anger.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us.
O my people, O my church, what have I done to you? Or in what way have I offended you? Testify against me. I led you forth from the land of Egypt and delivered you by the waters of baptism. But you have prepared a cross for your Savior.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy on us.
I led you through the desert 40 years and fed you with manna. I brought you through tribulation and penitence and gave you my body, the bread of heaven. But you have prepared a cross for your Savior.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy on us.
What more could I have done for you than that I have not done? I planted you, my chosen and fairest vineyard. I made you the branches of my vine. But when I was thirsty, you gave me vinegar to drink and pierced with a spear the side of your Savior.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy on us.
I went before you in a pillar of cloud, and you have led me to the judgment hall of Pilate. I scourged your enemies and brought you to a land of freedom, but you scourged, mocked, and beat me. I gave you the water of salvation from the rock, but you have given me gall and left me to thirst.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy on us.
I gave you a royal sceptre and bestowed the keys of the kingdom, but you have given me a crown of thorns. I raised you on high with great power, but you hanged me on the cross.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy on us.
My peace I gave, which the world cannot give, and washed your feet as a sign of my love. But you draw the sword to strike in my name and seek high places in my kingdom. I offered you my body and blood, but you scatter and deny and abandon me.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy on us.
I sent the Spirit of Truth to guide you, and you close your hearts to the Counselor. I pray that all may be as one in the Father and me, but you continue to quarrel and divide. I call you to go and bring forth fruit, but you cast lots for my clothing.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy on us.
I grafted you into the tree of my chosen Israel, and you turned on them with persecution and mass murder. I made you joint heirs with them of my covenants, but you made them scapegoats for your own guilt.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy on us.
I came to you as the least of your brothers and sisters. I was hungry and you gave me no food. I was thirsty and you gave me no drink. I was a stranger and you did not welcome me. Naked and you did not clothe me. Sick and in prison and you did not visit me.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy on us.
Holy God, your Son, Jesus Christ, carried our sins in his own body on the tree so that we might have life. May we and all who remember this day find new life in him now and in the world to come, where he lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
The Lord's Prayer. And now, our Savior Jesus Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this, our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, we pray you to set your passion, cross, and death between your judgment and our souls, now and in the hour of our death. Give mercy and grace to the living, pardon and rest to the dead, to your holy church, peace and concord, and to us sinners, everlasting life and glory. For with the Father and the Holy Spirit, you live and reign one God, now and forever. Amen. And send down your abundant blessing, Lord, upon your people who have devoutly recalled the death of your Son in the sure and certain hope of the resurrection. Grant them pardon, bring them comfort. May their faith grow stronger and their eternal salvation be assured. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.